internet. Today, we're going to be talking about a fantastic board game called Ticket to Ride. You've probably heard of this one. It's gained a lot of popularity when it first came out. And it's, like I said, with Apples to Apples, it's quickly becoming one of those games that even non-gamer people are keeping on their game shelf. It's made by Days of Wonder, who are really, honestly, becoming known as being a great game maker. They make a lot of really great games. And this particular one has won all kinds of awards all over the world, as you can see on the box cover right here. So, a lot of great things about this game. I'll show some of it when we get looking at the board of the pieces, but I gotta tell you, one of the things I really like about this game is the artwork. The artwork is just fantastic. Take a look at some of that artwork. It's just beautiful, beautiful artwork on there. And that the pieces are also really good quality, well-made pieces that also just look really good. When you pull out the board, it's just a nice-looking game. And I really like that aspect of it. And so, really, quite simply, the game is, it's about, the idea is that everybody sitting around the table plays a group of industrial-age adventurers who are all inspired by the famous Phineas Fogg, you know, the guy from that book, Around the World in 80 Days. You know, he traveled around the whole world in 80 days, and they were all inspired by him and decided they wanted to do something wild and crazy just like that. And they've done, you know, the idea is that each year they do something, then they challenge each other, and this year their big challenge is to see how many cities in the U.S. they can visit by railway. And so the idea is that you're one of these adventurers, and you're trying to create your paths across the country through through railways, to get to as many different cities as you possibly can. And you do this by placing little train pieces on the board, marking your path. And at the end of the game, it scores points, and at the end of the game, the one with the most points wins. So, that's enough talking about the game itself. Let's look right into how it works. Okay, Ticket to Ride. Now, this is a big, big game. It comes in this great box, as you can see. I showed you earlier. Here's the rule book to the game. It's, again, the artwork is just gorgeous on this. I love it. It's beautiful. It's got the inside of the box has all kinds of great stuff to hold all the pieces you need for the game. You can see the bags with the train pieces in it. Let's take a look at one of the train pieces really quick. Let's get a close-up look at one of those things. See, look at that. Look at that. Really finely crafted, nice pieces. They look really good. They're clearly passenger cars. It's really nice. I like them a lot. There's the decks of cards with some more pieces. Some nice wooden score pieces. Now let's take a look at the board. Big, 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 big board. Big board. Look at that thing. Just huge. It's a map of the United States, as you can see. And here's the West Coast over here. On the edge of the board and the outside of it, that's the score board, where you can keep track of your scores. You go along the game. It goes all the way up to 100, but of course you can score past 100. You just keep going around the board. Everybody will know that you're up past 100. And again, just look at the artwork on this board. Look at how beautiful this board is. It's just gorgeous. Down here, move these out of the way. Down here, there's the scoring. There's how you get points. For one train down, you get 1 point. For two trains down, you get 2 points. Then you get more after that. Three trains gives you 4. 4 trains gives you 7. 5 trains gives you 10. And 6 trains gives you 15. And then, of course, there's other ways to earn points. You can earn points by completing routes, and you can also earn points by having longest route. And there's a couple other things in there to do stuff like that. And but basically, how the game works is you get these cards, these blue cards here, right? You'll get your little hand of cards, and you'll keep those cards in your hand, right? So there's a typical hand of cards. This is almost a completely useless hand of cards. But let's take a look at these cards. You've got different colored cards with different types of train cars on them. The truth of the matter is the type of train car is almost entirely irrelevant. The rulebook's going to reference them by the train card type a lot, but really what you need to worry about is the colors of the card. You'll notice there's also colored train types, and here, those are your player colors. It's important to keep difference the colors of on the card as opposed to the colors of the trains. These are players. These are what you're going to use to buy your train tracks with. It's different, right? So look over here. Let's look over here, for example. We got these blue trains on the map here. They're on black pieces. Look at that. They're on black parts of the board, right? Because how this works is, you would have used three black cards to buy this section of track from Pittsburgh to Chicago with those three black pieces right there in the middle. Or you could have used three orange cards if you had had three orange cards. The cards are simply used to buy trains. The trains are all yours based off of which color you pick to represent yourself. And then you'll get a colored wooden piece that you'll use as your score piece to go around the board. Right? So, now, so for example, we got this. This is a red card. We got the blue card, black, and orange. So those can be used to buy colors of those types. Now, I said this was an almost completely useless hand because they're all different colors. With the exception of this one right here, you'll notice this one right here, the locomotive, the engine, it's a rainbow-colored card with all these different colors on it. So, like, what the heck does that mean, right? Well, here's what it means. Pretty simple. It's a wild card. You could use it to represent any color you want. So, if you had a route like, let's go back over here. Let's say you wanted this route from New York to Washington. You desperately needed that route from New York to Washington. I have one black card and one orange card, which would not be enough to buy that route normally. However, I have the rainbow card, the wild card, so I can use it to purchase either one. I can spend my black one and get those two black ones, or my orange one and get those two orange ones, and place my two cards right there, right? My two cards would just go right there. And then, bam! I now have the route from New York to Washington. And then I would spend those two cards, right? They actually get spent. They go like that, bam. And there they go, right? And then, of course, you can draw cards to fill out your hand again. And then there's also cards that are going to be out. You can choose to pull from the cards that are out or draw randomly from the deck. So the idea is that this way you can pull, it reduces some of the randomization a little bit. You can pull the ones that are out so that way you can get more of the colors you need. But at the same time, you're letting everybody else know which colors you're buying. So it's a question, it's a trade-off, right? Like, do you want to buy that color that you desperately need and let everybody know what color you desperately need, and then maybe they'll take them from you next round, or maybe get a couple of different colors and not let them know which ones you want, or maybe go completely randomly because the color you need isn't in there. That's always a possibility. Now they go on the trains go on the board on the tracks. Now let's take a look at some of these. You'll notice some of the tracks are bigger than others. They require more trains to get across. You have to have an equal number of cars to the number of tracks that you need to go on the board. So for example, if I wanted this track here from Kansas City to Denver, I would need to have four cards. They'd need to be four black cards or four yellow cards, orange cards. Four black or four orange. And of course, I could use rainbow wild cards in there all I wanted to make that work. But I'd need to have four. Plus, I'd need to have four trains to go there. Because this is the important part. When you run out of trains, that's the end of the game. The first person to run out of trains or only have one or two trains left ends the game, and then everybody scores. That's where the scoring starts. That's where scoring really starts. You score points as you go along. Like I said, you score points as you go along. As you place trains on the board, you get the points that go over here, and you move your little pieces along the board, right? But the big way to score points is with these cards, these other cards over here. These brown ones. These are tickets. These are route tickets. So let's take a look at this route. Let's say I'm the blue player here on this board, right? We got blue and green. Let's say I'm the blue player. I have this route. Denver to Pittsburgh. Well, I've already got Pittsburgh, and I've already started my route. I've gone Pittsburgh to Chicago, Chicago down to Kansas City, and now I just need to get from Kansas City to Denver. If I can just get enough cards to get from Kansas City to Denver, I'll have made this route, and that's 11 points. Right? That's 11 points plus the points I got for putting down all those tracks, right? So that's like 11 bonus points. That's really great. Now, meanwhile, this guy here, the green player, he's gone from El Paso to Dallas. No, I'm sorry. El Paso to Oklahoma City. And then from Oklahoma City to Kansas. And then he's gone up a little bit further from Kansas to Omaha. You know, maybe he's probably trying to get up here, possibly to Winnipeg, for a really long route and score some major points for that. Right? Now, hopefully, he won't know what I'm doing to go from Kansas to Denver to score those points. But I'll be honest with you, going straight across the middle of the map like this usually indicates that you've got some long route. There's a route, in fact, that goes from San Francisco all the way to New York City, and that's a big, huge, honking number of points. And if you can make that route work, that's a pretty impressive route. Now, you don't have to make the route work by the most direct line possible. right? So I'll give you an example of how this works. Let's say my opponent, the guy who's green, is kind of a dick, and he's going to go and he's going to buy these four black tracks right here and block me from getting from Kansas City to Denver. You meanie, you bastard. Look at that. He just blocked me, right? Now, the truth is, and you might think he's blocked me off entirely, right? Like, I can't go up to Omaha, I can't go down to Kansas City. Now, you'll notice there's two tracks right there, and you also notice those are gray. Gray means you can use any color, but they gotta be the same color. So, like, I couldn't just use this red one and this blue one to buy these two ones here between Kansas City and Oklahoma. I'd have to buy, they both have to be the same color. I have to use two blue, or two red, or two of whatever color I have two of. And that would be good right there. Or just one right here would work, right? Now, if it were a two-player game, because the rules do allow you to play two-player. If it were a two-player game, I would be completely blocked in right there. I wouldn't be able to buy either one of those two tracks. But if you're playing with more than two players, and you can play this game with up to five, I wouldn't really recommend it more than five. In fact, I don't think you can play with more than five. There's only five different colors. So you can only play with five. Then you can buy the multi-layered tracks. You can buy, each one can buy one of those tracks. So, like, I could still buy, if we were playing in a multiplayer game, I could still buy from Kansas City to Denver if I had the orange tracks. But we'll say this is a two-player game, so he's blocked me off. And it could be a multiplayer game, and let's say somebody else has also got those orange tracks, so, like, I'm still blocked off, right? So what do I do? Do I go up to Oklahoma and then down to Denver that way? I could do that. Or we could go back here. I've got Chicago. Let's say I've got blue cards, right? So I can spend my blue cards and buy this track to Oklahoma and hope I get enough pink cards to make it down to Denver. But again, it doesn't have to be that way. I could go to Pittsburgh, I could go all the way up here to Toronto, around to Winnipeg, down to Helena, and then down to Denver. As long as you can connect your cars from one city to another on your ticket, you've completed the route. It doesn't matter how you get there. It doesn't have to be the most direct line. And sometimes you don't want it to be the most direct line because at the end of the game, the player with the longest route gets more points. There's a lot more to it than this. I'm just going over some of the basics on how the game plays, but that's really basically how the game plays. That's really all it is. And like I said, when you get down to two, one, or zero trains, when one person gets down that low on trains, the game ends and you start scoring up points with tickets and longest track and any other bonus points that you may get in the game. And that's really all there is to it. And there you have it. And I gotta tell you, Ticket to Ride right now is probably one of my favorite board games. It's just fantastic. I think I'd rate it even above Settlers of Catan, which I haven't touched on yet, but it's also a really fantastic game. We'll get into that in another video. But Ticket to Ride, just a whole lot of fun. I've played it with 10-year-old kids, I've played it with 50-year-old adults, and everybody in between, and everybody just has a great time playing it. It's just a whole lot of fun. And that's really all I gotta say about this game. So until next time, keep playing games. Bye!